I made a completely custom, one-of-a-kind bike, but it didn't come without some challenges. So you can fully appreciate what went into this particular build, we need to jump back to the very beginning. Several years back, completely unrelated to Bolton e-bikes, there was a Kickstarter crowdfunding campaign for an e-bike frame called the Hop Mod. It was this cool vintage style frame, completely designed for e-bikes in mind, with a bolt-on bottom bracket that could be moved back and forth. The seat height could be adjusted up and down. There were plenty of holes for mounting batteries and other accessories. I was interested in the project. I wanted to see it succeed, and I still didn't purchase one. But a couple years back, someone I know on Facebook had mentioned that they were considering selling the frame that they had bought. And because it was one of those odd, one-of-a-kind opportunities, I decided to buy it. In the meantime, business got really busy. I didn't have time to mess with the frame. It basically got tossed in the attic and it sat there for a couple of years. Fast forward to 2021, and one of the major motor manufacturers reaches out to me and says, hey, we would like you to review our new motor and battery combination. I started searching around for potential candidates on conversions. Bicycles are pretty much sold out everywhere, so it didn't matter if I wanted a mountain bike, a road bike. My options were pretty slim. And then of course I remembered that frame that I had stashed away. This seemed like the perfect opportunity to take this new motor and battery combination and build something totally one of a kind. So this bike is a combination of basically all brand new parts, but some that may have been sitting around for a couple of years, to parts that were brand new that I just got within the last week or so. One of the first things, of course, you have to do on any bike build is decide on a cool color combination. So I decided to go with these red Juintech hydraulic calipers. And thankfully, I also found in one of my parts bins these matching red 203mm rotors. I did not, however, have a wheel set that would fit the bike, so I had to order two 26-inch rims. I couldn't order a standard set because I needed two distinct sizes. For what I wanted to do, I needed a quick release hub in the rear, but I needed a very large 20mm by 110mm through axle for the front. And that's because I had to match it up to this massive, I mean, just look at this travel. This is crazy here. We're never really gonna use all of that. But this massive D&M USD 8 fork, which of course I wanted so we could get this cool triple tree motorcycle style look to the whole bike. The headlight is something that I also had because I was going for the motorcycle look. I thought it'd be cool to put on some actual Michelin tires. These are bicycle tires. The frame came with this motorcycle style like seat, so I didn't need to do anything there. There were a few custom parts I had to make, and that's where the challenges come in. These red Juintech brakes do not have brake switches. These weren't originally designed for e-bikes. So what I did is added a sensor right here, and then there is a magnet embedded right here. So when you pull the brake, it pulls the magnet away that activates the switch. I 3D printed a custom piece that wraps around the end of the lever. It has a spot to hold the magnet just to get everything to look like it was designed that way. I also didn't have any hardware to mount this nice giant LED light. So this piece right behind the headlight is something I also designed and 3D printed specifically to mount on the existing holes on the D&M fork. So I had on hand the SRAM X5 9-speed shifter and the SRAM X5 9-speed derailleur. But that didn't go as easily as you might think to get this all mounted up. You see, this frame has horizontal dropouts that are designed for a single speed bike. So if you're using a mid-drive motor on this frame, typically what you would do is use an internal hub and you just have a chain or a belt with no derailleur here. But because I was trying to use parts that I had on hand, I had to mount a derailleur. But this shape right here, this is not how the frame was originally designed. Originally, it looked like the other side, like this. There was no room for the derailleur to go right here. In fact, there was no mount for a derailleur. So that required a few custom pieces that I was able to order. This piece here is a chain tensioner combination derailleur hanger. So this is a piece that you can buy that allows you to mount a derailleur to a single speed frame. The problem was with that design down here, it wouldn't actually mount. So I had to take a grinder and actually cut a big section of the frame out here. But it was a bit of a job to get this derailleur mounted up. Now that I've showed you the wheel set I've used, the brakes I've got on the bike, the headlight, you're probably wondering, what is the motor? And well, here it is. This is where the story takes a little bit of a turn. I put all of this work into the bike, and then just a few days before the release of this video, I was told, hold up, you can't release it yet. The official launch and release of this motor and battery combination is being pushed back. So this is my poor excuse of a camouflage job. Getting the motor to mount on this particular frame was another challenge that I had. Nothing wrong with the motor whatsoever. The bottom bracket that I had for this bike was way too thick for a motor that mounts like this one does. So I had to buy what's called an eccentric bottom bracket, which basically puts the bottom bracket mounting position off center to give me the clearance I needed. And unfortunately, when the eccentric bottom bracket showed up, it didn't fit into the shell that came with this frame. And then I had to fire up a lathe and turn down the brand new eccentric bottom bracket adapter I bought, and then press fit and hammer that back into the frame. That was probably the most time-consuming part that I made for this bike, but when it comes down to it, at the end of the day, I'm really happy with how everything turned out. I really love the look of the bike. It's a lot of fun to ride. I just wish that I could give you more details on the motor and battery combination. As soon as the manufacturer of those components gets back to me and says that, hey, the official release date is now, then you will see a follow-up video where we get to ride this bike. I'll show you what the performance is like. We'll go through all of the specifications on the display, the motor kit, the battery. Because this bike was a custom one-off build, unfortunately, it doesn't do me a whole lot of good to share with you a build list because you can't duplicate it even if you wanted to. The good news, however, is that the creator of this frame is potentially working on a new design, so more details will follow in the second video. I am going to sell this bike. Now, I have no idea, with this being a custom one-off bike, what it's worth or what it would sell for. It has some really unique things. So the best way to determine the value of this bike is to put it up for auction. So hit that subscribe button. This project was a ton of fun. I can't wait to share more. If you want to see other things that I've made, then here's a video on a tool I've made specifically for electric bikes.